Marc Varillat, winner of the International Tournament of Paris 1990. Second in the International Tournament of the URSS in Tbilisi 1991. Winner of the Tournament of Cameroon 1994. Workshop in Tenri, Japan 1994. Winner of the European Cup of the Champions Clubs with the Racing Club of France 1994. The Racing Club Judo Cars on the European Top 1993, Jean-Pierre Bess, heavy, Pascal Legout, 95 kg, Thomas Sakachvili, 86 kg, Bertrand Damaisin, 78 kg, Marc Varillat, 71 kg, Benoît Compargue, half light, Thierry Sarrazin, light, coaches Serge Feist, René Rombier. Mediterranean Games, Athens, Greece, 1991. Winner of the International Tournament of the United States, Los Angeles, 1993. Third in the French Championship, First Division in the Coubertin Stadium, Paris, 1993. Third in the team in the Military Championships of San Diego, USA, 1986. Winner of the International Championship of the Police in Oslo, Norway, 1980. Official poster of the Tournament of Paris, 1990. Backpiece worn by Marc Varillat during his victory in Paris, 1990. Marc Varillat, final of the less than 71 kilograms. Varillat beats Vey Marchese with the Watsa Ari.
Toujours, tout est bien, tout est bon. Il suffit de trouver le système qui nous convient. Voilà. Alors, en l'occurrence, moi, je recherchais plus trop les katas ou une optique de recherche interne. Je recherchais une optique de self-défense, d'efficacité. Et dans ce système, le Brésil est un pays très dur. Ils n'ont pas fait ce système pour des démonstrations. Ils n'ont pas conçu ça pour passer dans toutes sortes de spectacles. C'est vraiment une recherche d'efficacité première, comme on a pu le voir dans les championnats extrêmes comme l'UFC. Je donne des cours 4 fois par semaine, que ce soit en Italie ou sur la Côte d'Azur, à côté de Grasse. Je participe à tous mes cours, aussi bien tout ce qui est échauffement, préparation musculaire.
We'll be right back. Nous allons étudier les quatre familles de projection de judo que sont les techniques de hanche, les techniques de jambes, de bras et de sacrifice. Pour chacune de ces familles, je suivrai sensiblement le même plan. C'est-à-dire que je commencerai par une démonstration des techniques traditionnelles, une fois en kumikata à gauche, une fois en kumikata à droite. J'entrerai ensuite de manière approfondie dans les explications techniques pour les plus usitées d'entre elles. Je poursuivrai par une présentation de nombreux éducatifs, renforcement, exercices d'application spécifiques. Et je conclurai par une démonstration des applications pour la compétition, c'est-à-dire les variantes des techniques traditionnelles et les techniques nouvelles que la compétition moderne a su faire apparaître pour une plus grande efficacité.
Tournament of Paris 1990, less than 71 kilograms. 1/4 final. It's in 1990 that I win the International Tournament of Paris in the less than 71 kilograms category. I meet Philippe Torin in the final rounds. I take a first koka on an unweighted form of kata garuma. I take yoko on this side on the knees, very unrolled. Philippe Torin was a fellow citizen and a friend. We trained together at the INSEP. He was the strongest of the category, very strong muscularly, and very respected in the all-category championships, usually the category preferred by the heaviest, though slightly under the heavy category and the less than 86 kilos. He was very dangerous at the Sayonaga and the Kachiguruma. He was also familiar with the Eastern turn style of judo, because he also was a very good wrestler. He was one of the rare judokas to participate in the French Championship of Wrestling in a team, and this he did brilliantly. I will take several advantages against myself in this battle. I'm not the favorite, but I know that my strong point is resistance, so my principal weapon is harassment. I will impose a great rhythm, but I will also hack the combat in some sort of a way, so he doesn't have the time to construct nothing. For this, I will work a lot just underneath the surface, roll with the left arm and attack all the time in Uchimata Kenken. I mark Watsa Aria no Sotogari. This is when I win the combat. The technique goes as follows. With the upper part of the body, I feint to the front in Haraigoshi or Uchimata. On the obtained reaction behind, I hook an Osoto Otoshi. And two times, I placed Osotogari. So I won my third combat of the day. Before this, I worked against the Brazilian Freire in the first round and the representative of Great Britain, Ravenscroft, in the second round. Tarin won against the Canadian Deuxerre and the Czech Vanenke. Half finals. In the half finals, I encountered the Italian champion, Diego Bonbiglia. He's very strong on Yoko Tomoe and Sayonage. As he's very tall, I knew that it would be difficult to harass him with the upper part of my body and with the left arm. So I'll choose Kumikata often, crossed, which disturbs him a lot. During the day, he won against the French, Oliver de Pierre, and the Swedish, Daline. He tried Yoko Minage. I try an Uchimata Sumigeishi sequence, but too shy, Then I collect his legs, but I fail to be determined. My specialities are uchimata, osotogari, and sumigeishi in reaction to my uchimata. All this left-handed. I am left-handed in judo, although in all other activities I am right-handed. This is my first year in 71 kilograms. I am still not strong enough. I try to compense with a superior rhythm and a non-orthodox judo, very unbalancing. I take Watsari and this Ippon Sayonage on the knees by Banbilia. I mark Ippon and Uchimata Kenken. Finals. In the finals, I encountered the French Vincent Vielle-Machizé. He's very strong on Yoko Tomoenage. I take Yoko, and it works well. He's very strong on the ground. His teacher at the CDB was Jean-Pierre Guibet. He was grand specialist of the Nuwatsa. These are his third finals of the Tournament of Paris. He has two silver medals. He bent in 1989 and in 1986, facing the Japanese Yoshikata. During this day, he beat the Spanish Ruiz, European champion, the German Zimna, and the champion Serge Gaetan, himself winner against the Korean Chung. He tries Koso Togake. Morota Sayo on the knees. Collecting the knees coupled with the Tamiotoshi. It's on this collecting of the legs after a feint in Oslo to Otoshi that I might Wazari, which will make me win the tournament. It's one of my special techniques. I pull with the left arm so as to obtain a getting up behind as a reaction. I dive into this reaction with my right hand, I collect behind the knee, and I do Tami Otoshi or Oslo to Gake. My harassment does its job. Vincent takes Chido. I hope he doesn't mind me recollecting bad souvenirs of his, because I like him a lot. After his diving away, he tries Hitsaguruma, and it almost works. It was my day, but it took a lot of points against me all day long, and I clung to the branches a lot. But it was my spirit of the time, my optimism, that made me use my strong points for the best. I had the courage, and I won because of that. It was my first international selection. It was the beginning of 5 years in the French team, a very good learning time, and a time of personal perfectioning. First European Champions Club Cup with the RCF in 1993. RCF was the first club in 1988, in 1991 and in 1993. First tour. Where in 1993, the racing will win the European Cup of the Champions Clubs. The French Racing Club has already won two titles in 1989 and in 1991. The first tour is in France. We encounter the Saint-Honoré Reims Club. That's the club from Belgium. With a cross Kumikata, I mark Koka on my Uchimata Kenken, Sumigeishi sequence. I try Uchimata Kenken, Ko Ushigari sequence. I do yoga and sumigeishi with the same kumikata feint, crossed, Uchimata sumigeishi. I marked Ippon in the same collecting of the legs that made me win the tournament of Paris in 1990. It's underlined in this case with Tami Otoshi. Bernard Nicolas, judo president of the RCF. Second tour. We're in Holland for the second tour, amidst the Haarlem Club, the champion club of the Netherlands, with Frank Moreau, French champion of 1991, today sergeant in the Légion Étrangère. Benoît Campart, European champion in 1992, today national coach. Me in 71 kilos. Bertrand Damaisin, third in the European tournament of 1992, bronze medal in the Olympic Games of Barcelona in 1992. Thomas Sakajvili, world junior champion in 1990. Eric Farou, international. Jean-Pierre Besset, double French champion. Serge Fest, coach of the RCF and the French team. Oh, I try Ushimata Kenken Somigaishi. I start Uchimata Kenken. I try my collecting of the legs. I harass with my left arm very strongly. I mark Watsuari. On this technique I continue with an idea of Osoto Otashi, but the first leg escapes me, so I continue my speed on the leg inside. This made me kind of an Oshigari Ushimata sideways, but the basic idea was also to Otashi.
En Mark Verilot brengt de stand op 3-0 voor Racing. En daarmee heeft de Racing Club de kans deze avond gewonnen met 5-2. Wij hopen dat u, ondanks het verlies van Kerkbuur, toch genoten heeft van de avond topsport. Thuis en tot ziens!
One fourth finals. We're in the Czech Republic for the third tour, facing Luz Prague, the Champions Club of the Czech Republic. I can't make him let go of his kumikata. He plays with that. On my reaction, he plays as Watsuari with Araigoshi Makikomi. I try my collecting of the leg, it almost works. He tries his Araigoshi Makikomi. He marks Koshi Makikomi again. I take a penalty because I can get out of his kumikata. I harass, he begins to be tired. It's time for me to do Haraigoshi Makikomi. A Markoko Amauchimata Sumigeshi sequence, cross guard. I mark Ippon with my collecting of the legs coupled with Tami Otoshi. This is Tami Otoshi, predominant. I did not collect the legs with the hand, but you can still recognize my favorite. The team was strengthened by the presence of Thierry Sarrazin in the less than 60 kilograms and Pascal Leglou in the less than 95 kilograms, military champion of 1990 and finalist in the Paris tournament of 1991. One half finals. This is already my fourth tour. The half finals against the FC Berlin in front of their public. They are leaving European champions. I encounter Martin Schmidt, winner of the tournament of Paris in the same year of 1993. He's also the German champion of the time. The strain has passed. I don't give up, but I will lose in some points. He's strong. I have difficulties locking my kumikata. I take Watsa Aria on Tiguruma in counter of my Oso to Otoshi. His Uchimata Kenken went well. I lose. The finals against the Frankfurt Soda Champion Club of Germany have not been taped. I lose against Trumpleder, the military champion and the champion of the second tournament of Paris in 1992. But the team wins the finals after all. The French Racing Club wins the European Champion Club Cup for the third time in its existence. We share the merit with our trainers, Serge Fest, ex-European champion and a great help of the French team as a national trainer. René Rombier, also national trainer, and the prestigious strangers that succeeded each other, Shota Awazu, the English Adams, the Soviet Mitsarov, the Polish president Waldemar Degen, the only real double champion in two categories in Olympic, different weight in the less than 78 kilos in Seoul and the less than 86 in Barcelona, exceptional technically, tactically and as a human being. International, French team FFGDA, 14 international and individual selections. Third championship of the military world, USA 1987. First, in international tournament of Paris 1990. Second, tournament of Holland 1990. Second, tournament of the USSR, Tbilisi 1991. Replacing in the European Championship 1991. Pre-selection for the Olympic Games 1992. First, Tournament of Holland 1993. Third, Tournament of Monaco 1993. First, Tournament of Los Angeles, USA 1993. First, Tournament of Austria in team 1993. Third, Tournament of Monaco 1995. Winner of the European Cup of the Champions Club in 1993 with the Racing Club team. Second in the European Cup of the Champions Club 1994 with the Racing Club team of France. National, first individual division FFGDA. Fifth in 1988, 1989, 1990, 1991. Seventh in 1992. Third in 1993. National, 2nd Division FFJDA, French champion in team in 1996. Police, FSPF, European champion in 1998 in Norway. Vice champion of the European Police in 1992, Sweden. Police champion of France in 1987, 1988, 1989, 1991, 1992. Vice champion of the French police in 1998. The goal of this video comes from the following statement. It's one thing to know the projection techniques, but another to know how to place them in a position. The opportunities to play such a technique seldom come naturally. You have to create them. There are principal guidelines that permit to break the opponent's defense and that allow to lead him into a position where you are able to project him. This film is articulated in 7 chapters, each of which will present your principle or a main idea leading to your goal. The methods are studied separately for pedagogical reasons or for reasons of clearness, but in combat you would use several of them at a time for more efficiency. Action-reaction. In this first chapter, we will study the principle of action-reaction. So I will do an action that might be a simple action like pushing or tearing, or a more complex action like, for example, a sketch of a technique. The goal is to trigger the opponent's reaction. This reaction might just be a readjustment of his supporting points, of the balance, or something more structured. But the important thing is that the reaction will be generally logic to the attack, and that I might use this by anticipating a technique. The opponent will thus be late, and this will avoid a defense of his against this new technique. The first type of action-reaction, I push Uke downwards. This will make him get up again and I will use the time he needs for an attack. The push-in action is done with the entire body. You have to exaggerate the height during practice in order to be efficient enough in reality. You might do it in one spring action in order to avoid a prolonged action-reaction. Second situation. I use a reaction to the front now. I push both arms, I put on brutal pressure, and when he rebels against my push-in and lifts his arm in order to place his komikata, I aspire and I place my technique. Another technique. I stretch my arm and I move back my hips in order to loosen his komikata and to trigger a tear and a getting up of his. I use this reaction in order to come back brutally and very bent for my technique. The floating created right now has allowed me to turn, so I might do a squeezing technique on the other side or a hip technique on the other. This other method needs a hard tearing on the opponent's wrist. The action has to be brusque, a little height, like an electric shock. It might be doubled or tripled. The obtained reaction will be a jump backwards. It will be during this time of floating that you will place your technique, this time very high and very strong. This same floating should be obtained by an action on the collar, because we are now working on the breast. The electric shock has just to be strong, short and brutal. Another possibility is to do a sequence of techniques on an action-reaction time. I do a shimata in a very determined style with the upper part of the body. I just come out a little in order to continue with another shimata on his floating. The same frank Ushimata action of the upper part of the body, I come out in Ushibarai and his reaction behind. On this other sequence, I get out of his line of force by placing myself quickly in profile. Profit of his floating by placing an arai goshi action around the body and unroll with osotoshi on his reaction behind. Mount the action of the left calf on his part. Use the grip on the left foot on the ground before you approach with your right foot in order to be stable at all times, and the left elbow is lifted in order to take uke's head. For training, you may do the following pedagogical exercise. I do harai goshi with all my body, and on the left leg in front I execute azotoshi. On the right foot in front I do ushigari. On uke's legs that stay in the same position, I double harai goshi. Thank you. unforeseeable. In this second chapter, we will see that if you don't want your opponent to adapt to you, you have to be unforeseeable. The problem you represent for your opponent has to be complex and changing, so he can analyze it, he can avoid it, and can't adapt. The typical counterexample is to push in straight lines, always to the same side, too foreseeable. The other counterexample would be the fighter that has only grips to the right hand front in his repertory. The opponent would understand the danger too quickly, he would analyze it and avoid it. I take my classical left-handed kumikata, but I tear in bits. I do a push-pull action like a locomotive. This destabilizes more than staying in the same position. The problem changes, it is thus more difficult to solve. I might add some little sweepings of Uke's front leg to my action. This will divert him and avoid him creating an attack. You can also disturb your opponent by shaking his arms. I step back and I tear, and I open maximum in order to execute its zaguruma, for example. During training, one should not hesitate to exaggerate the height, because in combat the height will be reduced by the opposition. Another application, in opposing kumikata, I am dominated. If I tear, he will addition his force to my turn and attack. By tearing, I will thus have to push with the arm and with all my body, create the floating and make him, bit by bit, large enough to dive inside and to attack. Partial preliminary techniques. In this chapter, we will see that in order to unblock the situation or in order to win against a very aware and strong opponent, one might do a partial preliminary technique. The principle will be to do one first technique, not really in order to make him fall, but to gain time and space against Uke's defense. Then you might do a second decisive technique. Attention, if on the first technique we may limit height and the engagement in order to make the common sequence easier to begin with, you should by no means limit the intensity of your realization, because in this case you would be engaged in the battle. Tenitashi Tonitashi. I attack the first leg in order to do the whole movement afterwards. This double attack is done with four strong points only. One, two, three, four. Araigoshi, araigoshi. Act with the same principles, with araigoshi sweeping the hip. I show you Tayotoshi once again, tipping the body over by bearing. Always, while attacking the first leg in front, before you do the definite technique, ushigari, ushimata. I am left-handed. Ushigari hit with the left leg serves to make Uke's right leg move backwards, and it makes him bend a little. I do left, right, hit ushigari, and I continue left, right, ushimata. On the same register, I may reinforce the progressive destabilization and the disbalancing by doubling, tripling, or quadrupling my attacks. Ko ushigari, ushigari in front, before I place my definite technique. Always attacking the first leg in front before you do the definite technique. I will do a form of Deashibarai, hooked. If he doesn't take away his leg, he falls. So he takes it away, he avoids me, and in the sense of his balance, I continue with Araigoshi, or Osoto Otoshi. Here I want to take my kawakata directly, so I do Deashibarai in order to destroy his support, which would give Uke a chance to catch me in my flight. My kumikata is almost in stealth. I have to search the left hand. Then I do the same thing, Deashibarai on the first leg. His defense makes him bend forward. I use this to grab his sleeve. The partial technique serves this way to condition the opponent. In this case, this is done with two impulsions and half Ippon Sayonage in order to dive into Ko Ushigari on the reaction. Avoiding a problem. Our technique to solve a problem when it occurs is avoiding it. This is one of the great principles of judo. It is sometimes interesting to give in to or to get around the opposing force rather than opposing it to it. Sometimes one might even use the opposing force at one's advantage. Sometimes the opponent's force is easy to use. For example, when he pushes without thinking, I give in quickly by moving backwards or raising when he does not think I would. Here it's a guruma, for example. He will be easy to project and he is already unstable because of his senseless pushing. The same way, when he tears, just dive into the way of his traction, it will be easy for me to add my force to his in order to project him. But sometimes the force Uke uses is more complex and stronger. In that case, you have to bypass it. Uke is right-handed in this case. Control the rotation by his stretched arm. I pull him towards me, I let go, and I use the floating moment in order to put myself sideways quickly and to pass my arm on the inside. For more strength, I have to engage the shoulder too. Left-handed against left-handed. Uke is very strong and neutralizes me, so I have to bypass his force. Back right, I bend to get out of the line, I push with my left hand and I pull with my right as though I stretched a bow. This way I avoid him following the movement. I got out of his force, I come back on him with Osoto Toshi, left heel, and calf like this, the hips well in front. The left wrist and elbow lift in order to make his head go behind. A last bypass, my left hand is crossed on his shoulder in order to control his lifting up. When he lifts his arm, my right hand helps to make his gesture larger in order to create better contact. I continue bypassing his force and I make Uke follow my movement, pursuing my movement behind him. In the rotation, I put my left leg as a block and I throw Uke. Direct feint. In this fifth chapter, we will study the direct feint. We constantly try to surprise the opponent. As a matter of fact, your opponent will know where you're going after a while. The more you're engaged in your technique, the more difficult it will be for him to get out of it. But sometimes you might make the tactical choice to make a direct feint or to surprise him. This way you act without too much preliminary construction. I pretend to take the kumikata high and bend quickly. I come to contact very high, mutegari, sweep the leg with two hands, the same sensibility upwards, and I surprise my opponent low by sweeping his legs. Either by grabbing his thigh or by pulling his knee upwards. Here is a training to integrate these techniques better. I do ushikomi on my kata grip. I need to take kumikata like in combat with strength, all my body weight on, and on the fifth attack I go down to morotegari, the same exercise with o ushigari, forcing on the side. Still on the same exercise, collecting the legs. Another technique, I get my hand behind his neck, he avoids once, twice, the third time I go directly behind the other shoulder in order to catch his belt behind his back. At the same time I pull Uke towards me with the hip, his shoulder is well unblocked, I do araigoshi, makikobi, putting the entire body into the rotation. On the same feint, depending on his unstableness, I can also do osoto otoshi, makikobi. The same beginning and possibility to do a form of oshigari with a lot of force. You need to push the elbow and the shoulder on Uke's head in order to twist him and the side to take away his strength from his. Exactly the same beginning, but we finish with the form of very torn itsaguruma, pants and belt. In the beginning, the same feint as before, then we will see a different form of makikomi. It's almost the same turn around on the ground, called paluchek. The left arm passes over Uke's biceps, it takes his sleeve and squeezes tightly, so Uke's blow is stopped, blocked, and I unroll the body straight. The head turns to look behind. Here araigoshi makikomi. With the same arm action and in the form of seoi makikomi, I sweep as before and go down between his legs on the knee. I move as though for a roll into the front, Uke is unrolled. We close the chapter with a little eccentricity. We do an osotogari and I take balance left on Uke's left foot, while Uke is surprised I take balance on the right and I am advanced on his defense. Using strength. In some situations, it is interesting to use force to conquer when the opponent is very active, moves a lot, or if he is too much in defense when he is waiting for the counter permanently, and when he is thus dangerous to make a traditional construction. Place Kumikata so as to have a lot of strength on him. For more efficiency, we shall respect some important principle. First, the one concerning the engagement with maximum intensity. An iron arm can be with 60%. The second one is concerning the use of lifting force. Third, concentration of force on a little part of the opponent, for example the neck, the shoulder, rather than to spread it all on the body. I undo on the left, classical kumikata, in order to use a lot of strength, on the following, the left hand behind the neck, the right hand very high on the left collar, and even stronger variant, needing more time on the grip, the left thumb in the collar, another variant, using the lifting force, the left hand flat behind the head, very efficient for brutal and sudden action. In the heavy categories, one might sometimes stay for some time in these positions, but in the light categories, very vivid, you rather work like an electric shock, 5 to 10 seconds only, because we should not forget that we control the opponent's arm here. Pay also attention to the judging, stay 5 seconds in this position without being offensive, which would be punished. Two possibilities on these two kumikatas. First, the two arms in strength on the opponent's strong arm. I put on progressively. Second, both hands on his left collar. I pull, shaken, and I move away and I place the second hand. Three examples of attack possible with these kumikatas. First, I pull to the ground a couple of times with strength. If he doesn't react, he will fall on his knees and will be punished for avoiding combat. Second, I pull him towards me with strength, if he reacts, upwards, and Oshigari breathing in. Three, if he has just an average reaction, upwards, I do Ushimata Kenken. Lift the left elbow, press on Uke's neck, the right hand folds, elbow lifted, use all the body, the head turns quickly to the right shoulder, I enroll Uke until he gets to the ground. If I haven't squeezed his head well enough for him to oppose an arm on the ground, I catch the arm or I collect the shin bone and I pull towards me so he falls on the back. You can also use force with a traditional high kumikata. On the following techniques, Uke and Tori are left-handed. We will do an action-reaction with strength. Tori reacts by pulling, pushing in a circle, and no straight angles. The left arm should take Uke's face with it, the elbow is lifted, and Osoto Otoshi. Another way, Uke and Tori are sideways, very engaged. Tori breaks free with the help of his arm and of his head. At the same time, the left wrist and elbow do the bird, tonic, underneath Uke's chin. In order to take his head back and also to Otoshi, grand exterior turn. Another thing on a loco micata this time. My right hand takes the sleeve on the elbow rather than underneath. I push on the elbow to the side. With the other hand, I push with strength underneath the chin like they do in boxing. At the same time, I hook my left heel and also to Otoshi, push straight in the line and fencing feint to destabilize Uke, also to Otoshi. Uke is too much on his guard. I can do only traditional attacks. I would be countered. I pull down, shake, take away his supporting points. With koshis, if he uses his knee, he will be punished. 2. Still in order to make him be punished, I avoid him construction by the use of false attacks in a fast rhythm, pelvis to the front, legs in front very aggressive, kumikata very strong. If I am in the lead, I should not take risks. I should not attack a person fond of counters. He blocks constantly, and we would both be punished until my victory. Uke is still quite in defense, very bent to the front. I pivot on my left foot in order to get on his right. With my left arm, elbow lifted, I push on my opponent's neck with force. With the right hand, I pull his sleeves that I stick to my pelvis as far as possible, and I hook in Ushimata Kenken. I can also try to close him in the red zone, pushing him carefully, preferring the neutralized arm, locking his shoulders, arms apart, pulling as though you stretched a bow, and if he puts out the foot, he will take shui. If he stays in the red zone for 5 seconds, he will take shido. If he gets on one side when I open the door like this, he will follow an anticipated technique. The kumikata. We will finish with a subtleties of the kumikata grip. If you want to be efficient, you have to realize that kumikata is not just putting your hands on his judo gi. It means gaining a strong point on the partner, so you can act on him, and you can also prevent the opponent from acting on you. He can't express himself. We will see different procedures to get kumikata. The grip techniques, the defense, the blocks, the hooks, the flying attack, and all the ways to become dangerous from the beginning of the combat on.
Enfin, tous les moyens pour être dangereux dès l'entame du combat.
At first, you have to be in a good position. My control is tight. Without floating, I am very strong on Uke's body. 5 centimeters of pulled tissue correspond to 5 centimeters of the opponent, not one less. The attack on the judogi is stretched. Both hands act in synergy. You act as with a steering wheel. The kumikata is also a supporting point for my balance. I start to neutralize Uke's strong arm with both hands. Then I lift the other hand. If Uke wants to take it away, I pull it quickly and I lift it up immediately. This way, I avoid a grip of his. He can come in on me. Still on Uke, kumikata on the same side. I can also block his shoulder in front by crossing. I then take his sleeve, so I can attack now. Or I can wait to have a definite kumikata. A kumikata opposing mine on Uke. Now I put both hands on his strong arm. As before, I lift the arm and I am in kumikata. We will see this at the end of the chapter. I can also, coming from this kumikata, continue to a traditional kumikata. Before beginning with the block techniques, the hooks and the flying attacks, we will now do exercises in order to be conscious of the importance of kumikata. Uke will be in defense only. Go for cross kumikata. Go for cross kumikata and try to make him fall without grip. Go for kumikata on the same side and shake. Kumikata on the same side and try to make him fall without grip. Uke goes for a high kumikata, tori in defense, balanced, without crossing his feet, the hands active and the movement calculated. Tori should attack Uke's 2 sleeves. Start, both sleeves taken. Tori should attack, guard on the same side, start Komikata. Tori should attack with the hand on the belt, head blocked underneath the armpit, start Komikata. I have half a Komikata, I need to place the other arm. The same situation, the other half of my Komikata, I need it whole. We will study the Komikata blocks. Uke is left-handed, Tori is too. With my forearm, I do opposition in the pit of his elbow, chase the forearm like a window sweep. To the outside, the left hand can be lifted for more security. Block done, I can unroll, grab, and lift the left hand. I am in attack position. Second, more delicate possibility, rather than sweeping, I can just put my hand on Uke's left shoulder, contact, I unroll as before. I push Uke on his heels and I do Kushigake or Kozotogake. Third block, I block the arm or the left shoulder by crossing. My hand comes in as second security. Coming from the grip on the sleeves of the blocked arm, I can do a flying attack or take my time to take my Komikata entirely in order to pull Uke towards me and attack. Tori is left-handed, but Uke is right-handed. I pull towards me, I block once, twice, push on high, and I execute a technique. Here upon Sayonaga on my knees. Let's now see the floating attack. Uta takes my right collar with his left hand. I dive away with my upper body behind like a boxer who knows he will do it over again. I anticipate his action by moving back, turn and pull his arm. I attack in flight with Erisoi Nage on my knees. Second flying attack, I act the same way as before, but additionally for the first diving away, I push and hit on Uke, who will react automatically, coming towards me even quicker. I use his blow in order to win Araigoshi. Now they're getting free from Komikata. press the bracken free of one sleeve, unroll on the outside, unroll on the inside, close an oven quickly on the outside, left hand pushed on the outside while I take back my arm to the inside, use the leg's strength. Free the collar, now Tori left-handed, Yuki is too, right hand on Uke's sleeve, left hand over Uke's wrist, close to his hand. I push down, I use my back and my legs in order to get straight. If he is strong, I do the same exercise with repeated pulling and pushing. A second technique, the right hand on his wrist, the left hand grabs the tissue in the hole of his elbow on the base of the triceps. I push down to the outside, it hurts him, at the same time I turn to the right in order to make him let go. A third technique, I take just underneath his grip in order to disturb his little finger and to take force off his wrist. My right hand is on Uke's left collar, I turn to the left, tearing his fingers and putting his arm in hyperextension. A fourth one, Uke is right-handed this time, my left hand on my own left collar, my right hand on his sleeve, I turn left, pull on my collar and I push on his wrist. Getting the hand free on the neck, on opposing kumikata, I push Uke away by stretching my arm and aiming on his armpit, which hurts him. I turn suddenly to the right and break free my elbow and my shoulder to the inside. Second possibility, I push with both hands, execute a little traction downwards, and I use the reaction to put my head to the left, and I do an immediate attack in order to avoid being punished. A third technique on a left-handed now, the pulsion suddenly with all the body, kushi on the front leg and repulsion done with the right hand help me to loosen the grip and to pass the chin. I come back to the kumikata, crossed, adapted to opposing kumikata. You have to insist on a perfect block of Uke's shoulder. The block is obtained by the conjoint action of the right hand and the grip of the triceps, with the left hand that pulls underneath the left shoulder and the advancing stomach. Here are some techniques that are done with this kumikata, sumilashi direct, ushimata on Uke's reaction, sumigeshi. Thank you. A circular oshigari. A hooked oshigari, torn. Torn sasai. Osoto otoshi. The form of Oshimata Kenken. Collecting the legs. Another collecting of legs. Now you have to choose the techniques best for you, and you have to work them profoundly. Those will be your favorite techniques, your specializations, in judo words, meaning those you master perfectly well and that will allow you to use your potential. The goal is to try to have a speciality for each situation that you might encounter in combat. On the ground, you need specialization linked to the compass and favorite techniques for each situation given by hazard. Uke on his knees, uke between his legs, uke defend jujigatame, and so on. You need specialities upright first in order to mark ippon, of course, but also techniques aiming at koiko, like some little hooks or collecting of legs. Others in order to push the opponent, in order to seek chido or chiyu, forget him off the tatami, avoid him attacking or avoid him blocking afterwards. You also need specialities at the end of combat, be sure of the judge's judgment, if the combat was close, like beautiful fake attacks, etc. Work the techniques that make you win time when you win, and others to use time when you need to catch up. And you should leave nothing to hazard, it's the solution to have a very rich judo, rich and constructed.